everyone, my name is Iris Franz, and today we're going to continue to talk about market equilibrium. In particular, we're going to look at a changing demand. So when there is a changing demand, what will happen to our market equilibrium? So we're going to start with our first case, increase in demand. So suppose we start our initial equilibrium with demand curve D1 and supply curve S1. In their intersection, we see the original equilibrium price P1 and equilibrium quantity Q1. And suppose we're in the market of organic food. And now suppose there's a campaign about organic food, telling consumers, hey, organic food is good for your health because there are no pesticides in it, and it's the most natural, and you should eat more of that. And suppose consumers are influenced by that campaign, and they start to think, I should consume more organic food because it's good for my health. So that would change the preference of our consumers, shifting their demand to the right. So there will be an increasing demand for organic food. So after the shift, we're moving from D1 to D2. And at the new intersection of D2 and S2, so your new demand curve and your supply curve, you will see the new intersection. And then that will tell you the new equilibrium price, P2, and the new equilibrium quantity, Q2. So you can see that when there is an increasing demand, that is going to shift our demand curve to the right, which will increase our equilibrium price, and it will also increase our equilibrium quantity. So that's what happens to our market equilibrium when there is an increase in demand. Now we're going to move on to talk about a decrease in demand. So suppose we're in the market of cigarettes, and each time you go to see your doctor say, oh, smoking is bad, don't even start. If you are a smoker, quit today, otherwise you'll get cancer tomorrow, things like that. And when you go to buy cigarettes, you see some warning on the pack of cigarettes saying that you will have lung cancer if you smoke. And sometimes they even show you a very ugly picture of the lung of a smoker. So you will say, maybe I'm not going to smoke, that's too scary. So you can see all this are going to decrease your demand of cigarettes. So when there is a decreasing demand, we are going to shift our demand to the left. And now you can see comparing to your initial quantity and price, you can see our initial quantity is Q1, that's intersection of D1 and S1, and price was P1, that was the initial equilibrium price. And after the shift of our demand curve, you see a new intersection, and then you mark your Q3 and P3, that's a new quantity and new price. So you can see that when there is a decrease in demand, then that's going to lower your equilibrium price, and that's going to lower your equilibrium quantity. And now you'll be able to analyze an event when there's an increase or decrease in demand. What you have to do is this. First of all, you draw your diagram, mark your initial demand curve as D1, initial supply curve as S1, and their intersection, you find P1 and Q1. And after you shift your demand curve, then you will have a new demand curve, you mark it a different D, say D3 or D2, whatever that is. And you will have a new intersection, so you'll have a new price, a new quantity, comparing the old price and new price, comparing the old quantity and new quantity. Then you know what will happen to your market equilibrium. Thanks for watching, and good luck with your studying.